Hello, my name is John Hay. I'm an extension educator with the University of Nebraska Lincoln Extension. I focus on energy and biofuel issues here in Nebraska. I'm going to talk about how ethanol changes gasoline, and I'm going to focus on octane. Octane, by definition, is a relative value given to fuel representing its ability to withstand compression without igniting. You can imagine that premature ignition of fuel in the engine could damage the engine. Early anti-knock agents or octane boosters were things like tetraethyl lead, leaded gasoline. Lead turned out to be an environmental issue, and so the industry has moved to other types of octane boosters. Things that they can use are aromatic hydrocarbons, ethers, alcohols. It's called an octane because the compound octane or the molecule octane is used as the basis for that relative comparison. Let's think about a four-stroke internal combustion engine. In those four strokes, the cylinder pulls in an air and fuel mixture into the cylinder. It compresses it here on the second stroke. Then we move to the power stroke where we have a spark and that fuel ignites, followed by the exhaust stroke where we're pushing the exhaust gases out. If you could imagine a situation where as we compress that fuel spontaneously ignited and we would get knocking and pinging. And so what we need is a fuel that can withstand the compression before and only ignite at the time that it is sparked. If we look at the octane ratings of different types of fuels and chemicals, we see isooctane here at the top has a octane rating of 100, and that's just by definition because when we compare everything to it, we set the isooctane or octane at a number of 100 and then we compare everything to it. That's not to say that your fuel contains octane. It may or may not. It contains a number of hydrocarbon chains, different lengths of chains, but when we test them in an engine, we compare their ability to compress without igniting to the isooctane, which is why we call it octane. You also see that there's three numbers here: the research octane number, the motor octane number, and the anti-knock index. The research octane number is a measure of slow speed knock, or a test when the engine is not under load. The motor octane number is a test of high speed knock, or when the engine is under load. And then finally, the anti-knock index, which is the average of the RON plus the MON divided by 2. That anti-knock index is important because that is the number that we see listed as the octane rating on our gas pumps here in the United States. So when you see a gas pump that says 87, that is referring to an anti-knock index of 87. And you'll see this R plus M divided by 2 typically on the pump somewhere. It's important to know that there are different measures of octane because if we were to travel to other countries, we would see a sticker on their pump that might be much higher than what we see in the United States. And the reason is that they're reporting typically the research octane number, and that's just the number that they've gotten used to. And so some of my travels, I've seen some very high octane ratings, and you would perceive that their fuel has much higher octane than ours here in the United States, but that's not necessarily true. What it is that they're just reporting the research octane number, and we're reporting the average on our pumps. U.S. regular gasoline is 87 octane, and most vehicles require a minimum of 87 octane to run properly. Some high-performance vehicles are going to require higher octane fuels, such as 91. The octane number is only giving you information about the fuel's ability to compress without igniting. And so a higher octane fuel does not necessarily have more energy. But the reason sometimes we perceive that is that a high-performance vehicle has higher compression or compresses the fuel more in the cylinder. And because it compresses that fuel more in the cylinder, it requires that higher octane fuel to be able to withstand that compression. And higher compression yields greater efficiency in an engine and thus potentially more power in that and from that engine. And so sometimes we perceive higher octane fuels as having higher power or higher energy. That's not necessarily the case. The octane rating does not give us that information. And I would expect putting a higher octane fuel in my vehicle would give similar performance as a standard octane fuel based on the energy content of those fuels, which is not reported to me. So how does ethanol change gasoline in relation to octane? Ethanol is going to increase the octane. It's used as an octane booster. Ethanol is 100 octane, so it's RON plus MON divided by 2 is equal to 100. And that's for 100% ethanol. Sometimes you see reported that ethanol has a much higher octane rating, like ethanol is 112, and both are true, and that's an odd thing to think about. And the reason that both are true is that the blending octane value of ethanol is closer to 112. When we blend ethanol with gasoline in small amounts, like the 10% blend, ethanol increases the octane as if it had an octane of 112. Until we get out to higher blends, and then ethanol's octane is going to be more like what it is at 100%, which is 100. And so ethanol is a low-cost octane booster in today's marketplace and is thus very common as an additive to boost the octane of that fuel. For more information, please visit my website, bioenergy.unl.edu. This presentation has been brought to you by the University of Nebraska Lincoln Extension.